And let's talk about Netflix's new series coming out July 7th, and that'll be Castlevania. Now, if you don't know what Castlevania is, I really don't know how to help you. Now, this is a game that I've never played in probably the 10 or 11 iterations that it's had, but I've always known about it. It's always one that I thought was cool. When I was a kid, I wanted to play it, but you know, our parents were like, it's too violent. You can't play that one. Huh?
I'm surprised. I thought you had played it at some point, like not long after it was on the NES, but... Okay.
And this is a game franchise that's been around since 1986. So if you don't know what the game franchise is about, I'll give you the most basic of basic rundowns. It's about this family of vampire hunters called the Belmonts, and the different iterations of the games do follow different members of the Belmont family. And they're out hunting vampires. Now, I believe they killed Dracula in the first or second game.
I think he's a recurring villain, right?
Yeah. The only means a vampire. You can keep bringing those guys back from the death. This one will be following, they said the story is going to follow more of Castlevania 3, which was, I believe, released in 1991. And so they are actually going for a game, which I find interesting, because at first, when they first announced everything, they kind of made it seem a little ambiguous that they're just going to, you know, take the story, the Belmonts fighting, you know, vampires, and just build on that, which
generic
I actually
enough.
Preferred.
Yeah.
Huh?
Straightforward enough story that you can do okay, a family of vampire hunters, and here's vampires, there you go,
fair enough, here, let's do it, you know. And but this one, it's interesting that they're going to be taking it off of a game. And again, the reason I kind of get a little nervous when I hear you are going to be basing off a game is because the translations don't usually work. The only things that do usually work are when you don't realize they're not trying to rip straight from the game. They're not trying to recreate the game in movie format, because games are great because that's the way they're made. That's just like books do lend themselves better to movies than video games lend themselves to movies. There's just so much more, I feel like, in a video game than even in a lot of books to be told. Well, so it's a lot
of the interest in the video game is the interactivity and the mechanics. It's not, yes, there are a lot of great stories in video games and a lot of great visuals in video games now and everything, but that's not the primary thing except for a few recent games. But not the Castlevania series. Castlevania series had a lot to do with mechanics and fun factor of interactivity.
And that is what people love. They love the puzzle solving. They love the platforming of that series. And that's really what entrenched it in the mythos. Like, even when they tried to do other things, like I think Nintendo 64 had a Castlevania game that wasn't very good because it was more of an action adventure Zelda type game. And so whenever they try to veer off of their platforming puzzle solving roots, people tend not to like it too much. But so this one is going to be, it's being created, produced, something like that, by Adi Shankar. And now, if you don't know who Adi Shankar is, check him out on YouTube. He's got a lot of really cool things. Like, we talked about a couple of his things a while back. He did the Power Rangers Unauthorized thing, where it's like a 15-minute supposed to be like trailer for a fake movie, and it was really, really cool. He did one with Judge Dredd. He did a Judge Dredd series that people really loved. And he did also, I want to say he did The Gray, the Liam Neeson movie. And what am I missing? He did a Punisher one called Dirty Laundry, which are these short films that are 10 to 15 minutes long, most of those, except for The Gray. That's a full feature length. But they're amazing. Like, I mean, they're really well done. They're really cool. Mm-hmm. And he does always take an interesting look at the series. Now, he doesn't take it and he doesn't remake The Punisher. He doesn't remake Power Rangers. He just twists it a little bit and puts it out there. And it usually works really well. And so that'll be cool. And one thing that people are kind of not happy about, which I don't understand, especially if you are a big Castlevania fan, is that this will be a animated series instead of a live action series. And I think that's the better way to go, in my opinion. I just think having an animated series, you can get more of the video game feel. And if you watch the teaser trailer, it does look like they'll have some of the ultra violence that you can get in animated things. And they'll really go with more of the video game type feel. And I think if you really are going to base it off of a game, that this is the best way to translate that feel. Like, a lot of people thought that they were being gypped by not having a live action one, but I think this is the way to go.
Yeah, this makes sense to me to have it as an animated series, because then you can also try to tie in the art style that is already well known from just the cover, from the games as they are now or were then, and just try and get it closer in that sense. And probably also I mean, animation costs a lot of money, but we're talking about probably elaborate sets for this particular
one. Yeah, I mean, they would, this is Netflix. They wouldn't do it half-assed. Netflix really wouldn't do it half-assed. They would go all out like they did with Marco Polo, like they've done with all their other things, the Daredevils, the Marvel properties. They would go all out and put a big budget into it. And I think you probably are saving money doing the animated way. Now, we have talked about previous episodes how there is problems with animators, and it does look like they're going more the anime style, so that type of animation instead of more the American type animation. So I don't know if they have to go to Japan to get these, but one thing about this is it will be, I believe what I read was it's going to be a 4-part first season and another 4-part second season in 2018. So it won't be a long series, doesn't seem like, but if they have 4-hour long episodes, you could probably tell a good amount of the story there.
Well, I mean, if it's based off of Castlevania 3 specifically, that was on the original Nintendo, I thought.
So it can't be.
I thought that they got the third, or that, or maybe it was on the Super Nintendo. But there's only so much story there to get through.
For the sake of not having to water down the story and really change up the plot a lot, or add a whole bunch of plot devices that just don't fit, you have already pared it down, making it 4 episodes, and the animation, I am excited about it. I really am. Now, I've heard about rumors about this show for a while, but I'm starting to get hyped for this. It comes out on July 7th, so we're not that far away from it. And this is a show I can imagine myself, and I don't like to say this because I don't particularly like to watch shows this way, but I'll probably watch all 4 episodes in one sitting. Just probably how I'll go, and then we'll review it on the show, and then I'll have watched it and Brendan won't have, and it'll be an awkward review because Brendan won't say anything. And
I mean, this is honestly one that I might actually watch. It'll be an anime.
What? A series. I hope the camera's on me because this is my surprise face.
I might, knowing that it's coming out on July 7th, that it's only 4 episodes, so it's not like I have to put a huge amount of investment in it.
I mean, and I'm hoping they're actually the 4 Netflix like anime 5-minute long episodes, hopefully more than just a half hour. I don't know. I don't like watching animated things for an hour. I don't know why. I think animated things should be half hour episodes. Live action should be hour, but I don't know. I don't know why I have that preconception.
I don't know. Well, fine.
Whatever. Just is what it is. But hit us up. Let us know what you think. Are you excited to have a Netflix series? Would you rather be live action or animated? Let us know. Comments down below. Of course, at Words From My Face on Twitter, Google Plus on Facebook. Oh, it's a good way of getting a hold of us. But let's keep